NASA is just 24 hours away from launching the world's most advanced weather satellite.
Yeah, a panel previewed it today, looking at its capabilities and new tech that will help us all here on the ground.
GOES stands for Geostationary Operational Environmental Satellite. The U is for the number of satellites that came before it, starting with A. This is video of the GOES-U aboard a Falcon Heavy rocket. Hurricane forecasting is going super high def.
This example that you're looking at here was from way back in 2017. It shows Hurricane Maria. We're able to scan these big storms as frequently as every 30 seconds in order to get minute-to-minute warnings out to the public.
Cat 4 Maria knocked out ground radar on the island, the only updates coming from space. The GOES-U refreshing data to Earth every 30 seconds equals improved accuracy and tracks. Forecasters will now have the ability to look inside the storm to measure the water vapor amounts, helping predict strength. Another key upgrade, lightning detection.
In this example here, you can see the flashes of lightning occurring within the eye wall of this hurricane. Research is underway now to better understand how to make use of that data. What does it mean when we have lightning in the eye wall? Does it mean the storm is strengthening, weakening, or sort of remaining the same?
That every time you get a new piece of data, you see things that's like that you haven't before, and you learn from that, and you put that into the research to operations, and that really feeds new operations, which is absolutely incredible to be able to do that.
Wildfires, volcanoes, even the sun will be watched and recorded around the clock. Space weather, including solar flares, will be monitored through a new instrument called the coronagraph, important for power grids, communications, and even astronaut safety.
In a sense that we'll be able to see these explosions off the sun within 30 minutes of taking the pictures. It's in the hands of the forecasters and also in the hands of the public.
Better views and information from 22,000 miles up, cutting-edge protection at home from all kinds of weather events, including hurricanes.
The more that we can observe and understand conditions in these boundary layers of tropical cyclones provides us the best information for forecasting storm changes.
Meteorologist Eric Burris will be covering tomorrow's launch. If the launch is successful, it will take another several months to get the satellite in the just right spot, test it out, and then start beaming that data down to Earth. Data that meteorologists like...